Hello everyone, my name is Andrei Dima and I'm a travel photographer. Most of my photos and videos are shot using an ND filter. And today we will take a look at a variable ND filter from Sandmark. Sandmark is a brand that is making phone and action camera filters for a long time. And now they started making filters for camera lenses. I used their GoPro filters in the past and I was very pleased with the results. This is an ND8 to ND64 that provides between 3 and 6 stops of light, which is great because you don't get that X from cross-polarization like other variable ND filters. This type of filter is useful when you are shooting outside in bright conditions. Most of you already know what an ND or a variable ND is, but still, let me quickly explain it. Variable ND filters allow you lower shutter speed, so you can use the 180 degree rule to get that nice cinematic motion blur in your footage. This means you have to set your shutter speed to double your frame rate. So if you shoot in 24 frames per second, your shutter speed should be 1 over 48, or on some cameras 1 over 50. Here are some frames from the video so that you can see the difference between the 180 degree rule and faster shutter speeds. Also, if you shoot using the 180 degree rule, your footage is going to be overexposed without a filter, as you can see here. It is also useful when you are recording in HLG or log profiles that demand higher base ISOs. Variable ND filters are very useful in photography as well. If you want to do a long exposure during the day, to make the water soft in your images, or give a sense of motion to the clouds, or maybe you want to create something more artistic. With a variable ND, you can achieve those results by lowering your shutter speed. You can even use them at night to decrease your shutter speed from 30 seconds to maybe 5 minutes, making some surreal photos. I use them most of the time for time lapses to add a bit of motion blur and make them more interesting. Now let's talk about build quality. It is made from industrial grade aluminium and multi-coated cinema glass, and it is very thin, 7.2 millimeters. Because this filter is so slim, there is a downside. You cannot put a lens cap over it. Maybe in the future iterations, Sandmark will provide a rubber cap or even a magnetic one. And you can order it in these sizes: 58, 67, 77 and 82 millimeters. The ring has slight stops markers on it and has hard stops on both ends. Now let's talk about the optical quality. I've tested this on my 45.6 megapixels Nikon D850 and multiple lenses and on my Fujifilm X-T4, and I have found no decrease in image quality, sharpness or contrast. The only thing, and this is not a downside, it makes images a bit warmer. But if you adjust your white balance, there is no color shift. Overall, this is a high quality variable ND filter. It is well built and has no image quality problems. Sandmark did a great job with this one. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. This helps me grow my channel and make more videos for you to watch. See you next time.